What's good, Raider Nation? Y'all know who it is. Y'all know what it is. It's your boy, Matthew Shaq. And I'm just laying back, relaxing and contemplating where do we go from here. Raiders, we got our asses whooped. Can't say it any nicer than that. By a rookie quarterback by the name of Justin Fields and the Chicago Bears, 20-9. And we ought to be ashamed of ourselves to play the way we're playing, especially having somebody come into our house and totally dismantle our entire team. One thing over here, man, don't make excuses, man. But when you're talking about circumstances, they need to be brought up. But there's no excuse to playing like that. Can't use the distraction of the John Gruden scandal, because now it's at scandalous stage now, as a reason why we didn't play well. Because there was no scandal last week, the week before that, when we played Justin Herbert and then when we got our doors blown off. So there's no excuses, man. You know, we haven't been playing well for 2 weeks. So I think that this had something to do with it. But at the end of the day, these guys are supposed to be consummate professionals. You're supposed to protect your home field, and go out there and play a lot better than that. But let's get down to what didn't happen. Number one, the offensive line. That offensive line is the worst offensive line in football. I don't give a damn who you got back there. You could put the late great Ken Stabler behind that line. He's not getting it done. You could put Jim Plunkett behind that line and getting it done. You could put Marcus Mariota behind that line. He ain't getting nothing done. And we already saw what happened with Derek Carr. Without an offensive line, man, you're not getting anything accomplished. We couldn't get the running game established. Why? Because they weren't blocking. We couldn't get the passing game established. Why? Because we didn't get no pass protection. And when DC went outside of the tackles and started throwing the ball around, putting the ball in people's hands to get positive yardage and first downs, Darren Waller dropped two passes. Bryan Edwards dropped a damn touchdown pass right in his hands with no defender. Not focus. That could be put on the head coach. Head coach too busy dealing with his transgressions and the things that he did 10 years before. Don't matter if it was 20 years before. Don't matter if it was 50 years before. What matters is it's affecting the psyche of the football team. Shouldn't have to be dealing with this, man. But then again, we weren't playing well anyway. John Gruden's play calling, atrocious. It just gets worse and worse as the weeks go. That 4th-and-1 call was, you know, a perfect example of running the same play over and over and over and over again. Doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. Play calling is horrible, man. He needs to give up the play calling reins to Greg Olsen. Let Greg Olsen be the offensive coordinator and call the damn plays, because the plays that he's calling, they don't work. They don't work, period. Okay. As far as the defense did what it could do. Defense is beat up, did what we can do. They held them to 20 points. It should have been a lot worse. But hey, man, when it's 3 and out, 3 and out, 3 and out, 3 and out, the offense isn't giving the defense any time to get any rest or to get any type of recovery for the previous series. Hey, man, I don't care who it is. You can't stay out there all day, man, chasing people around while the offense is going out there. They don't even break in a sweat and you're out there sweating bullets. So we had that situation. In regards to people talking about, did John Gruden lose the locker room? That's going to be remain to be seen, man. I don't think you're going to lose a locker room in one day. I think that there's some situations going on with the locker room. But we've seen people lose the locker room. Remember when Jack Del Rio, this last year in Oakland, how he lost the locker room? That happened over a course of a few weeks. So I don't think one game is going to get it done. I think if we get back on the win side of the street, it'll be harder to tell, man. But when you're taking L's like this and you're still doing, you have to answer all kinds of questions that nobody on the team should have to answer. This is for John Gruden to answer. Nobody on the Raiders had anything to do with what he did. He wasn't an employee of the Raiders. He was an employee of ESPN. And to have these guys have to answer questions about stuff that didn't have anything to do with them is totally unfair. It's just wrong. You know what I'm saying? These guys, that's not what they come to work for. Imagine if you had to come to work to answer questions to the public about something that your manager did 10 years before when he wasn't even working for the company. You wouldn't want to be having to answer those damn questions. You'd be like, what does that got to do with me, man? So I totally understand that. That's what it is, you guys. Fortunately for us, we got some help yesterday. The Chiefs got their asses whooped. I was very happy to see Josh Allen and them and Bills Mafia coming through in the clutch to help Raider Nation out. And then the Steelers and their fan base, even though we understand our history, hey, man, the enemy of our enemy is our friend. And guess what? They handled that business with the Broncos. So we're still sitting in second place. But we're not going to keep getting bailed out. We're going to have to save ourselves, man. Ain't nobody going to come through that door and save us but ourselves, man. We're going to have to figure it out. But the way it's looking right now, season's starting to get long. And it's not looking like things are going to go the way that we hope them to go unless the team decides to look past everything that's going on and get their heads down and lower their pads and make some shit happen. All right, man. Love all y'all out there, man. On to the next game. 3-2. 3-2 is decent, but it ain't going to be good enough to win this division, man. We got to start kicking some ass and taking some names. All right, man. Love all y'all out there, man. Raider Nation for life. Salute.